Hello everyone. Our today's topic is about time and clock. We will be learning about what is clock, how it works, how we read time through clock, how many hours in a day, how many minutes in an hour, and many more. This is a clock which shows us time. A clock in general has 12 numbers written on it, from 1 to 12. It has an hour hand and a minute hand. The time is usually based on 12-hour clock. The hour hand, the shorter of the two hands, complete one rotation in 12 hours in a normal 12-hour analog. There are 24 hours in a day, and each hour has 60 minutes. We tell the time as o'clock, which means according to the clock. For the minute hand, the distance between each number equals to 5 minutes, and it is equal to 0 when it is pointing towards 12 on the clock. We add 5 minutes each time the minute needle moves from one number to another. For example, on this clock, the minute hand is pointing towards 12 and the hour hand is pointing towards 3. Therefore, we read the time as 3 o'clock. However, on this clock, the minute hand is facing 1 and the hour hand is facing 3. So we read it as 5 minutes after 3 o'clock. The minute hand completes circling the clock in 60 minutes, which is equal to 1 hour. Therefore, when the minute hand completes the circle once, the hour hand moves from one number to the next. We use AM and PM to show which part of the day we are talking about. We use AM to talk about time from exactly 12 o'clock at midnight till right before 12 o'clock in the afternoon. While we use PM to tell the time between 12 o'clock in the afternoon and right before 12 o'clock at midnight. For example, Hassan goes to sleep at 9 p.m. at night and wakes up at 7 a.m. in the morning? If it is 3 p.m. in the afternoon, what will be the time after 3 hours? It will be 6 p.m. Now, if the time on the clock is 9:20 p.m., after 3 hours, it will be 12:20 a.m. This is called elapsed time. The system of those sequential relations that any event has to any other, as past, present, or future, indefinite, and continuous duration, regarded as that in which events succeed one another. We hope now you have learned about the clock and its function. If some concepts are not clear, then replay the video again and again. Still, if you have some questions, then ask your teacher.